How do they figure out what kind of weather it's going to be? How do they make these weather reports? Well, we have a few ways of measuring the factors that affect the weather. Factors like temperature, air pressure, the amount of rainfall, humidity, and the wind. So let's take these one by one. First up, temperature. Now, how many times have you heard people saying, "Oh, it's so hot today," or "I feel so cold"? Well, the degree of hotness and coldness of anything is known as temperature. We measure this temperature using a thermometer. A thermometer is basically a glass tube with a shiny liquid called mercury filled inside it. Now, depending on the temperature, the mercury expands or contracts within the tube. When the temperature increases, the mercury expands. And when the temperature decreases, the mercury contracts. And this is how it shows us the temperature. That's how we measure the temperature to find out the weather of a place. But you know, temperature alone is not enough. The second parameter is the pressure that air exerts on us. This is what we call air pressure. But how do we know exactly how much the pressure is? Well, the instrument that helps us in measuring Earth's air pressure is called the barometer. It's an inverted glass tube immersed in mercury. The air pressure pushes down on the surface of mercury, making it rise through the tube. The height to which the mercury rises depends on the pressure that the mercury experiences. When the pressure is more, the mercury rises high. And when the pressure is less, the mercury falls low. Now comes the third parameter, the rain. You might have read in the newspapers, right, that it rained 100 centimeters or 125 centimeters. Well, how can the rain be measured in centimeters? For that, we have an instrument called the rain gauge. The rain gauge consists of a funnel that is attached to a marked cylinder. The diameter of the cylinder is fixed. When it rains, the rainwater gets collected in the cylinder. After it stops raining, the height to which the rainwater got collected is measured. That height is mentioned as the amount of rainfall. So when we say it rained 100 centimeters, this means that the water rose up to the height of 100 centimeters in the rain gauge. So that's how you can figure out the weather based on the amount of rainfall. The next factor that decides the weather of a place is humidity. Humidity is basically the amount of moisture present in the atmosphere. The water vapor in our atmosphere is the moisture of the atmosphere. So humidity measures the water vapor in the air. More water vapor means more humidity. The humidity of a place depends on its temperature. As the air gets warmer, its capacity to hold water vapor increases. And so it becomes more and more humid. On humid days, our body feels sticky and we feel hotter. Let me tell you why. When we feel hot, we sweat. Due to our body's heat, the sweat gets evaporated and we feel colder. But humidity messes up this process. When the humidity is high, there is already a lot of moisture in the air. Hence, our sweat cannot evaporate as fast. So it remains on our body for long, making us feel hotter and uncomfortable. Similar science applies to drying of our clothes as well. On humid days, the water from wet clothes has no space to evaporate. Thus, our clothes dry slowly. In this way, humidity affects our daily life. And this is the reason why we measure humidity in a weather report. And now, the final parameter, the wind. The moving air is called wind. You've experienced wind, I'm sure, in different intensities too. Gentle winds make wind chimes sound nice and musical. The heavy winds can uproot trees. So how do you measure the wind? Well, you can find out the direction using something called a wind vane. The wind vane has an arrow mounted over a cross and a rooster on top for whatever reason. So the wind vane is also called a weathercock. The cross has four ends, each directing towards one of the four directions: north, south, east, and west. When the wind blows, the arrow turns in the direction of the wind, and thus we can know the direction in which the wind is blowing. Now that we have all the parameters, we can predict the weather of a place.
If you like this video and want to watch many more amazing videos like these, like and subscribe to our channel now.